Welcome back. This is part two of this lesson. We're going to continue immediately from the end of part one, so let's get started. Okay, so now this instance is running with 2 out of 2 checks, then we're going to go ahead and install WordPress and copy across the assets. So select this instance, right click, select connect, select session manager, and then click on connect. Once connected, just go ahead and type sudo bash and press enter to move to an elevated security position. Now again, we're going to be running commands during this stage of the demo series, so I do recommend that you open this lesson's text instructions, and these are attached to this lesson. Now to get started, we need to do a software update on this EC2 instance, and to do that we'll use the yum update command. So copy and paste that from the text instructions and press enter. You might see some updates or it might not update anything. Both of those are fine. In my case, it just means that this instance is already updated. Next, we're going to install the Apache web server and the MariaDB database software. Now, we're not going to use the database. We're just using this to install the command line tools. So go ahead and run this command, and this will install Apache and MariaDB, specifically the command line tools. And this will take a few minutes. Once it's complete, I'm just going to clear the screen to keep this easy to see. And then I'm going to install PHP 7.2 because this is a prerequisite for WordPress. So I'll do that using this command. Again, that might take a few moments, but it will install the required software. Once it's done, I'll clear the screen to keep this easy to see. And next, we need to make sure that the web server is both started and set to start every time the instance reboots. So to do that, I'll use both of these commands. So systemctl enable httpd and systemctl start httpd. Now that's WordPress and all of its prerequisites installed. Next, we need to make it so that we can transfer the content from the on-premises web server across to this server. Now we're going to be using secure copy to perform that transfer, and to make it easier, we need to allow logins to this EC2 instance using password authentication. So to do that, we're going to edit the etc ssh sshd config file. So use this command, and that will open the config file for editing. And then scroll down, and we're looking for the password authentication prompt. So this is the prompt we're looking for. It says password authentication no, so we need to delete that and just type yes. Then we need to press Control O to save and Control X to exit. Next, we need to set a password on one of the system users in order to connect to this instance. So we're going to set the password on EC2-user. So to do that, we're going to use this command. Now the password that we're going to set is this password. In production, you'd have lots of different strong passwords, but we're going to keep them simple so that this demo works without any problems. So we're going to use the same password for the DB password. So copy that into your clipboard. Move back to Session Manager, press Enter, and it will prompt you for the new password. So just go ahead and paste that in and press Enter, and then paste it in again to confirm and press Enter. And that will update the password of EC2-user. Finally, on this instance, we need to restart the SSH daemon so that this config will take effect. So use this command, service space sshd space restart, and press enter. So that's this part done. So next, go back to the EC2 console and just go to running instances. You're going to need the private IP version 4 address of AWS CatWeb. So just note this down somewhere safe because we'll need it in a second. Next, we're going to go to the simulated on-premises WordPress virtual server. So this is CatWeb. So just right click, go to connect, again, choose session manager, and then click on connect. Now, once we're on this instance, we're going to copy the entire web route from this instance across to the AWS web server. So first, type sudo space bash to elevate your permissions. Then we need to move into the web folder. So cd space / var / www. If I just do a listing, you'll see that it has CGI-bin and HTML, and it's this HTML folder that we're interested in because this contains all of the assets and configuration for WordPress. Now we're going to use this command. This is secure copy, and this is going to copy the HTML folder to this destination. So EC2-user at, and then the private IP address of the AWS Cat web server, and then it's going to copy it into this path. So we need to replace this placeholder. So hover the cursor over the colon and then just delete this placeholder. Stop at the at sign. You'll need the private IP version 4 address that you copied down into your clipboard earlier of the AWS Cat web server. Paste that in here. Press enter. You'll be prompted to confirm the authenticity. Go ahead and type yes and then press enter. You'll then be prompted for the EC2-user password. And this is the password from the parameters of the CloudFormation template. Remember, this is what we set EC2-user's password to be. Paste that in, press enter, and that will copy all of the WordPress assets from this server to the AWS instance. Now that will take a few moments to complete. Once it has completed, we can close down this tab. Just go back to Instances, select AWS CatWeb, right-click, connect, select Session Manager, and click on Connect. We need to elevate our permissions again, so sudo bash. Now we copied those web assets into the home folder of the EC2-user. So type cd space /home/EC2-user. And then let's just do a listing, so ls space hyphen la, and we can see that we have the HTML folder that we copied from the on-premises side onto this instance. We're going to move into that folder, so cd space HTML. This time if we do a listing, you'll see all of the WordPress assets and configuration. We're going to copy all of these files recursively, so this level and everything below it, into the webroot folder. So copy star, and then a hyphen uppercase R for recursive, and we're copying all of this into var www.html. So go ahead and type that and press enter, and then I'll clear the screen to make it easier to see, and then the next block of commands in the lesson instructions will correct any permissions issues on those files that we've just copied. So copy the entire block and just paste that in and press enter. This might take a few moments, but this corrects the permissions on all of those files that we've just copied. Now at this point, this instance should now be functional as a WordPress application server, and it should be pointing at the on-premises database server. So let's test that out. Let's go back to the AWS console and go to instances. Let's copy down the public IP version 4 DNS name of AWS CatWeb into our clipboard, and then open that in a new tab. If everything's working as expected, you should see the same Animals for Life Hall of Fame, and this is being loaded from the AWS WordPress instance, but it's pointing at the on-premises database server because all we've done is copy across all of the assets and the configuration from the on-premises application server through to the AWS application server, and so it's still pointing at the on-premises database server. Now at this point, that's everything that you need to do in this stage of the demo series. In the next stage, you're going to perform the database migration and then update the configuration of the AWS application server to point at the RDS instance. Now, before you do that, you need to make sure that the RDS instance has finished provisioning. So go back to the AWS console, click on Services, move to RDS, click on Databases, and make sure that the A4L WordPress database is in an available status. If it's not, then you need to pause and wait for that to be the case before moving on to the next stage. At this point, though, that's everything that you need to cover in stage 3 of this demo series. So go ahead, complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you moving on to stage 4.